In today's video, I'll be exploring the flashback, what it is, why writers use it, and some potential pitfalls to avoid. If you're new here, my channel LitGrit is dedicated to providing you with expert analysis on books, poems, and plays, so if that sounds interesting, please consider subscribing so you don't miss out. I post new videos twice a week, and I'd love to share my thoughts and ideas with as many viewers as possible. Let's begin with a definition of what a flashback actually is. A flashback is a literary technique in which a writer begins a narrative in the present and, at a specific moment or moments, takes his or her reader back into the past. This is a popular technique among film writers too. Therefore, one reason writers use flashbacks is to fill in the gaps in a more interesting and efficient way than the usual chronological approach. For example, instead of spending page after page recounting a character's childhood, a flashback to a specific moment or incident allows the writer to convey important information in a relatively short amount of time, particularly if a character's backstory is complicated. As a result, the reader gets to know the character a little bit better, especially if the flashback is related from the perspective of the protagonist, although this may in turn raise questions about the narrator's reliability, such as Jean Forrester in a separate piece by John Knowles, which I review on this channel. In addition, a flashback may also help to create sympathy or even empathy for a certain character who has so far been unlikable or difficult to relate to. Flashbacks can also be thought of as creating a different, though interconnected, story to the main narrative, a bit like Russian dolls that open up to reveal something new to the reader. Examples of novels that use this device include a separate piece, and if you want to watch an overview of this novel, then please click the card in the top right-hand corner now. The novel The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak, and one of my all-time favorites, Brideshead Revisited by Evelyn Waugh. Some potential drawbacks of using flashbacks is that they take the reader away from the story happening right now, which may cause us to lose interest in the main plot. Moreover, if the backstory gets too complex or even irrelevant, it may confuse or bore the reader and leave us unable to distinguish between what's happening now and what happened in the past. Lastly, too much information in a backstory can feel like an info dump, thereby breaking one of the rules of successful fiction, to show rather than tell. Nevertheless, flashbacks are enduringly popular and do have their place if used with purpose and not at the expense of the present narrative. So, what do you think? Are flashbacks necessary, or is the reader better off without them? Let me know in the comments down below, and if you're considering using a flashback in your own writing, I'd love to hear what you think. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this video useful. I upload new videos twice a week, so if you want to make sure you don't miss out, please hit the subscribe button and bell icon now. Thanks, and see you next time.